keeping up with our motto, let learning be a joy and teaching a pleasure. Here we are with the remote teaching and learning process to bridge the gap. Happy learning, students.
The subject mathematics, standard 8th, topic equation in one variable, part 1. Name of the teacher, Mrs. Snehal Sarvaiya. Chapter 12, Equation in One Variable. In this video, we will learn what is the solution of equation in one variable and practice set 12.1. Let's recall, the value of the variable which satisfies the given equation is called the solution of the equation. Solving an equation means to find the solution of the equation. The equation obtained by performing the same operation on its both sides does not change its solution. Using this property, we obtain new but simpler equations and solve the given equation. The operations done on the both sides of an equation are to add the same number to both the sides, to subtract the same number from both the sides, to multiply both the sides by the same number, to divide both the sides by the same non-zero number. Practice set 12.1. Question 1. Each equation is followed by the values of the variable. Decide whether these values are the solutions of that equations or not. First, x minus 4 is equals to 3. The values for x are minus 1, 7 and minus 7. First, substituting x is equals to minus 1, LHS, that is left hand side, is equals to minus 1 minus 4. So we will get minus 5. RHS is equals to 3. Therefore, LHS is not equals to RHS. So x is equals to minus 1 is not the solution of the equation. Now we will substitute x is equals to 7. LHS is equals to 7 minus 4, that is 3. RHS is equals to 3. Therefore, LHS is equals to RHS. Therefore, x is equals to 7 is the solution of the equation. Next, substituting x is equals to minus 7, LHS is equals to minus 7 minus 4, that is minus 11. RHS is equals to 3. Therefore, LHS is not equals to RHS. Therefore, x is equals to minus 7 is not the solution of the equation. Second, 9m is equals to 81, m is equals to 3, 9 and minus 3. So first we will substitute m is equals to 3, LHS is equal to 9 into 3, that is 27, and RHS is 81. That means LHS is not equals to RHS, therefore m is equals to 3 is not the solution of the equation. Now we will substitute m is equals to 9. So LHS is equals to 9 into 9, that is 81, and RHS is also 81. So LHS is equals to RHS. Therefore, M is equals to 9 is the solution of the equation. Next, substituting M is equals to minus 3. LHS is equal to 9 into minus 3, that is minus 27. RHS is equals to 81. So LHS is not equals to RHS. Therefore, M is equals to minus 3 is not the solution of the equation. Question 2. Solve the following equations. First, 17p minus 2 is equals to 49. Solution, adding 2 to the both the sides. So 17p minus 2 plus 2 is equals to 49 plus 2. Therefore, minus 2 plus 2 will get cancelled. 17p is equals to 51. Now, dividing both the sides by 17. So 17p upon 17 is equal to 51 upon 17. 17, 17 will get cancelled, we'll get only p is equals to 3. Therefore, the answer is p is equals to 3. Second, 2m plus 7 is equals to 9. First, we will subtract 7 from both the sides. So, 2m plus 7 minus 7 is equals to 9 minus 7. Therefore, 2m is equals to 2. Now, dividing both the sides by 2, 2m upon 2 is equals to 2 upon 2. Therefore, m is equals to 1. So, the answer is m is equals to 1. Third question, 3x plus 12 is equals to 2x minus 4. Subtracting 12 from both the sides, so 3x plus 12 minus 12 is equals to 2x minus 4 minus 12. Therefore, 3x is equals to 2x minus 16. Here, now we will subtract 2x from both the sides, so 3x minus 2x is equal to 2x minus 16. Therefore, x is equals to minus 16. So the answer is x is equals to minus 16. Question 4. 5 in the bracket x minus 3 is equals to 3 in the bracket x plus 2. First, we will solve the bracket. So 5 into x will get 5x minus 5 3 is a 15 is equals to 3 into x 3x plus 3 2 is a 6. Adding 15 to both the sides, so we'll get 5x minus 15 plus 15 is equal to 3x plus 6 plus 15. Therefore, minus 15 plus 15 will get cancelled, so we'll get 5x is equals to 3x plus 21. Now, subtracting 3x from both the sides, so we'll get 2x is equal to 21. Now, we want x alone, so we will divide 2 on both the sides. So, 2x upon 2 is equal to 21 upon 2, so x is equals to 21 upon 2. Now, next, 5th. 9x upon 8 plus 1 is equals to 10. First, we will subtract 1 from both the sides. So, we will get 9x upon 8 is equals to 9. Now, multiplying both the sides by 8 upon 9, we are taking the reciprocal of 9 upon 8. So, we will multiply both the sides by 8 upon 9. So, 9x upon 8 into 8 upon 9 is equal to 9 into 8 upon 9. So, we will get x is equals to 8. So, the answer is x is equals to 8. 6th. Y upon 7 plus y minus 4 upon 3 is equals to 2. Multiplying by 21 throughout, because 7 into 3 will get 21. We are taking the LCM. So multiplying by 21 throughout, y upon 7 into 21 plus y minus 4 upon 3 into 21 is equals to 2 into 21. Therefore, we'll get 3y plus 7 into y minus 4 is equal to 42. Again, we'll solve the bracket. So, 3y plus 7y minus 28 is equal to 42. So, 10y minus 28 is equal to 42. Now, adding 28 on the both the sides. So, 10y minus 28 plus 28 is equal to 42 plus 28. Therefore, 10y is equal to 70. Now, dividing both the sides by 10, we'll get 10y upon 10 is equal to 70 upon 10. Therefore, y is equals to 7. Question 7. 13x minus 5 is equals to 3 upon 2. Multiplying both the sides by 2. So 2 in the bracket 13x minus 5 is equals to 3 upon 2 into 2. 26x minus 10 is equals to 3. Adding 10 to both the sides. So we'll get 26x is equal to 13. Dividing both the sides by 26. So 26x upon 26 is equal to 13 upon 26. Therefore, x is equals to 1 upon 2. So, answer is x is equals to 1 upon 2. 8th one. 3 in the bracket y plus 8 is equals to 10 in the bracket y minus 4 plus 8. First, we will solve the bracket. So, 3y plus 24 is equal to 10y minus 40 plus 8. Therefore, 3y plus 24 is equals to 10y minus 32. Subtracting 24 from both the sides, so we'll get 3y plus 24 minus 24 is equal to 10y minus 32 minus 24. Therefore, 3y is equals to 10y minus 56. Subtracting 3y from both the sides, 3y minus 3y is equals to 10y minus 56 minus 3y. Therefore, 0 is equals to 7y minus 56. So now we will add 56 on both the sides. So we will get 7y minus 56 plus 56 is equal to 0 plus 56. Now, answer is 7y is equal to 56. Now, we'll divide 7 on both the sides. So, 7y upon 7 is equal to 56 upon 7. So, y is equals to 8. So, the answer is y is equals to 8. Question 9. X minus 9 upon x minus 5 is equals to 5 upon 7. First, we will cross multiply. So, 7 will multiply x minus 9 and 5 will multiply x minus 5. So, after multiplication, we will get 7x minus 63 is equal to 5x minus 25. Taking like terms together, so 7x minus 5x is equal to minus 25 plus 63. Therefore, 2x is equals to 38. Now, dividing both the sides by 2, so we will get x is equals to 19. So, answer is x is equals to 19. 10th, y minus 4 upon 3. Plus 3y is equal to 4. Multiplying by 3 throughout. So y minus 4 upon 3 into 3 plus 3y into 3 is equal to 4 into 3. Therefore, y minus 4 plus 9y is equals to 12. Therefore, 10y minus 4 is equals to 12. Adding 4 to both the sides. So 10y minus 4 plus 4 is equals to 12 plus 4. Therefore, 10y is equals to 16. Now, dividing both the sides by 10, we'll get y is equals to 16 upon 10. That is, y is equals to 8 upon 5. we have reduced the fraction. So the answer is y is equals to 8 upon 5. Now 11th one, b plus b plus 1 plus b plus 2 upon 4 is equals to 21. First we'll multiply both the sides by 4. So we'll get b plus 1 plus b plus 2 is equals to 84. Now open the bracket. So we'll add b, b, b. So we'll get 3b plus 3 is equals to 84. Now subtract 3 from both the sides. We will get 3b is equal to 81. Now dividing both the sides by 3. So 3b upon 3 is equal to 81 upon 3. So b is equals to 27. So the answer is b is equals to 27. Thank you.